Welcome to Glasgow, where a misty morning has given way to bright sunshine. The conditions are perfect for the 2016 Bank of Scotland Great Scottish Run. There's plenty of enthusiasm, plenty of local support for the emerging marathon talent that is Callum Hawkins. A joint start then for the 13.1-mile journey. Well, a talented lineup for the Great Scottish Run over the half marathon distance. The first to be introduced, Betsy Siner. What a performance in Rio with that fifth place, sub 31 minutes in the 10,000 metres. She's a real talent. And of course, Chris Thompson, a former European 10,000 metre silver medalist, turned now to the marathon, going well. Has had some success in the Great Run series over the last two or three seasons. Well, Doris Jangewo was second last year, incidentally, sub 70, 69.50 last year. So we'll see whether she can improve on that. Behind Edna Kiplagat, of course, on that occasion. Well, Moses Kipsiro, well, defending Great Scottish Run champion. And what a champion, twice the Commonwealth champion over 10,000 metres, got such a finish on him. 53 seconds in the 2010 in that Commonwealth for the last lap of the 10. What about that? Well, Hella Kiprop, late entry actually into this, but world championship silver medalist in the marathon. That was in Beijing last year. What a talent. We'll see what she can do. Well, Callum Hawkins is coming of age, really. Such a good performance in the London Marathon at the beginning. That was in April this year. And then, of course, to achieve such a fine finish in the marathon in the Olympic Games, coming in ninth place. So there is a sprinkling of the talent, and personal stopwatches clicked as always on these occasions as the starter gets them underway. Big, big field of marathon runners of all sizes, all shapes and all abilities, as is always the case in these major city half marathons. And it will take a long, long time for some of them to get over that start line, and then they'll see ahead of them a very stiff uphill run to the first mile or thereabouts. So times over the first part of the course will be somewhat reduced. Look at those stopwatches being clicked as they go over. There is that hill. And I tell you what, it's a good course, this. It really is, as they make their way up that tall hill. And then, of course, they'll be told, start slowly and then go a little bit slower for those who are unfamiliar. But the course itself, it's down St. Vincent Street to begin and very close to George Square, and that's out towards that first mile. And then it'll turn left past the hydro there and all the way down Kingston Bridge and heading south now, down eventually St. Andrew's Drive and into and around Pollock Park and then back up again towards the 7 miles, and as it turns, bears left once again, heads up around Bella Houston Park and at 9 miles and heading towards 10 then. Ibrox Stadium there, then looking at the Clyde Arc, the Squinty Bridge so-called, and then back along the long run, Clyde Street, Glasgow Green and the finish. Good course. Fairly flat, slightly different this year. But my goodness me, as one always expects, the elite get away, don't they? There they are, Thompson, Hawkins, Kipsiro, Tweldy, Kimutai, Mengisteb. Those that one would expect to be up there are there. And, well, Chris Thompson is who takes over the lead. As I said, he's turned to the marathon now. It's 2:11.19 is best marathon performance thus far, and I would think that he's had so many injury problems, really. Callum Hawkins with the dark glasses on the left of your shot now, in very good form at the moment. And I just wonder whether Kipsiro, who, as I said, was twice 10,000 metre champion in the Commonwealth Games, 2010, 2014, only just won it, though, in 2014 by, I think it was about 3/100ths of a second, if I remember correctly. It was such a close encounter. But certainly the early pace, well, with that big hill, I guess they're running it around about 64, but that will improve later in the race, I'm sure, as the course itself flattens out. Some of the hills are no longer there. And there is Betsy Siner. And I have to say, she is a real talent. When you consider that performance in the Olympic Games over 10,000 metres in what was a world record event, wasn't she? She got a best of 69.27, incidentally. That was set last year, and that was in Boston in the United States. So her form is really current, and I just wonder, this may well be her first half marathon of this season, incidentally. I haven't got a figure for her this season thus far. But surrounded by the men, and that's how it will be, and that will be most helpful to her. And still they come over that start line, and they will be for some considerable time. There'll be office workers, there'll be track runners from clubs who have done something of consequence in their clubs on the track. There'll be those who turn to the road for the very first time. There'll be money raised for charities, as such is the way of these distance races in the United Kingdom. Number four is 12D, was fourth last year, incidentally. It's Sega 12D, his allegiance transfer from Eritrea, incidentally. And he's just got off the back of that group, and well, he might find himself in no man's territory soon, unless he can make it back into that leading group. But there are now five away from the rest of the field. Kimutai in the yellow on the right, and Joel Kimutai, he's 27 years old. He's got a best, incidentally, of 61.39, just to give you some idea of where we are. But this race now beginning to unfold already. Five away. 12D then, as I said, fourth last year. 63.34 is best last year. That was fourth in this race last year. So he's got to make a little bit more headway if he's going to catch that group. I think he's just dropping off the back, and I think it's now down to five. Now, Callum Hawkins in that group, second last year behind Kipsiro, incidentally. He ran on that occasion 62.42, which in fact was at that time his personal best. But since then, he has improved to 62.39, and that was in Paris. He was that was in March this year. He was in 10th place on that occasion. Well, there's Hella Kiprop, I should say, the Kenyan, and the marathon silver medalist from Beijing last year, just 1 second behind the winner, Mara Dibaba. That was a fabulous performance. There's Beth Potter behind her, and then Doris Cheng-Yewo. So the women are, but they're way down on the leader, I'm told. Betsy Seiner must be almost a minute ahead already. Kimutai, Kipsiro, Hawkins, Thompson, the lead group. 16.29, 16.30 gone. So they're between 3 miles and 4 miles now. And this, and they're running. It has improved a little bit. One would expect that once they've got away from that early hill. They're running around just around 63-minute pace at the moment. So that's pretty useful. Kimutai on the left. Got a marathon best of 2:11.51, incidentally, set that this year, and 61.39, which is his personal best set this year, in the bright yellow on the right. Callum Hawkins in the middle, and Kipsiro, of course. And I just wonder whether Chris Thompson, in the red strip on the back of those three, is going to be able to stay with them. Well, when you look at Betsy Seiner, a former student at Iowa State University. She was there for 5 years, incidentally, won pretty well all there was to win in the NCAA championships on the country and on the track over 10,000. But a student of public health at that university. But my goodness me, she is really flying. 69.27 this year, as I said, or rather in 2014, as I said. This is her first run this year over the half marathon distance. So it looks to me as though she is running around about, 68-minute pace, probably a little bit around there at the moment. We'll see. But I'm expecting negative splits on this race. I really am. The course is a little bit flatter, and Hawkins has gone, and Thompson, as I thought, has now dropped off the back. Just approaching Pollock Park now, and that will be approaching the... Well, in advance of the 4 miles, they're approaching 5 miles. We'll be able to give you, and I think they've speeded up a little bit, having left Thompson there. That indicates to me that they've pushed it along a little bit, and we may well see that once we get some idea on the next marker, I think they're much quicker, and I think they're getting quicker and quicker in this race as they approach Pollock Park. 23.31 gone, and that is closing in on 5 miles, and that is now, well, it looks to me around about 62 minutes. Well, they have speeded up, and I just wonder whether Betsy Seiner, I reckon she's running around about 68, and if the what you're seeing with the men is repeated here, then she could well be under 68 minutes, and that would be a race record, and certainly the men's race record would certainly go. You can't compare the time of Haile Gebrselassie, really. It's a different course. There we go, 6 miles, 28:28. And I think they're just under 62 minutes now. So that's started at 64, then to under 63, then 62 and a half, 62, and now they're under 62 minutes. So this is very quick. Because remember, last year, when you look at Callum Hawkins' personal best, 62.42 set here last year. He's won, as I said, he's gone better in Paris, but he's looking good here, isn't he? Those two marathon performances this year have given him such confidence. Unbelievable confidence. Ninth in the Olympic final. He was 27th at halfway and came back to ninth, and that tells you a lot. Coached by his dad and his brother, incidentally. I think he was 14th, if I remember correctly, in the Olympic Games. So what a family affair it is. Kipsiro, last year's winner. Now, which of them will win this year, or will it be Joel Kimutai? Kimutai, incidentally, was fourth in the Briton Marathon this year, and paced Tokyo, so there's a lot of experience in those legs too. Well, the men will soon be emerging from Pollock Park, incidentally. Let me give you a few mile times. The first mile, well, we know it was slow, 4:45 because of the hill, then 4:59, 4:39, 4:41, and the fifth mile, 4:29. And that's what took them just under 62 minutes. And then 4:44, and then it's pretty well the same, I think, for 7 miles. They're roughly, it's pretty constant at the moment. Ah, there is the second place, Ahila Kiprop of Kenya, and that's Daniel Bradford of the Shaftesbury, Shettleton's Harrier, just leading her and acting as a bit of a pacemaker, really. And but the leader, well, Betsy Seiner is so far ahead of the rest of the field, and I reckon she's going to dip under 68 minutes at the rate she's going at the moment. It's very constant, her pace. But I would expect it to speed up a little bit at the moment. But she's in the middle of that group, so on her own. So if she can latch on to one of the men there, then, well, who knows. But anyway, Kipsiro looks to me to be just pushing to the left ahead. Callum Hawkins is there, and Joel Kimutai. Those three are way, way away from the rest of the field. Chris Thompson wasn't able to stay with them. And they're now 7 miles, and that's 7 miles. In 33 minutes, actually, it's a little bit earlier, went through seven a bit early, 4:41 on that last mile, and that is 61 and a half minute pace. So they have speeded up dramatically. And remember that personal best, well, 62:39 for Callum Hawkins, so he's running well inside what he's achieved before. And Kipsiro, well, he has got a 60:41 to his credit. That was last year in New Delhi. Betsy Seiner, then. I reckon still on course for something around 68. It may be a bit quicker than that because she really is motoring, although she is on her own. But the men now, oh, look at this. This is Joel Kimutai, has been dropped off the back, and it is a repeat of last year between Moses Kipsiro of Uganda and Callum Hawkins of Great Britain and the Kilbarkan Club. The Scot in great form at the moment, coming off those two marathons this summer. And really, has he got the sort of pace that can see off Kipsiro? Remember, I remember watching him in 2010 in the Commonwealth Games. He had a 53-second last lap. More about that in a moment. This is a young woman absolutely in full flight. Betsy Seiner came here. She's coached by Jerry Schumacher and lives in America. She won the Great Manchester 10K, incidentally, last year. So we mustn't forget that. She's been in the UK before and has won races, but looks very, very determined indeed. I reckon that she's going to run sub 68. Looks good, doesn't she? Absolutely out on her own. Bella Houston Park now, and look at that. Kimutai can't stay with these two, and Hawkins putting the pressure on. Callum Hawkins, look at that. Kipsiro now, 2 or 3 metres off the back of him, can't draft on that. He's got to get back to him if he needs to draft off him. But Callum Hawkins digging in. Fabulous performance here. And remember, Callum ran his first marathon in Frankfurt in 2:12:17 last year, set the personal best in London at 2:10:52. There's so much more to come over the full marathon distance, and success and building on these half marathons is great preparation. Big lead now over Kimutai. It's down to 2. Lots of entertainment in Pollock Park as the masses pass through. Thousands and thousands of them. The Pipers encouraging, as often they do. Hawkins, Kipsiro, Africa versus Great Britain. Beyond 10 miles, and the 10th mile was... Oh, look at this. They just got those 4:21 at 9 miles. That was where the break came. 4:20 at 10 miles. Well, that is superb, and that means they're sub-61. That is incredible. Well, this is going to be a race record, certainly. You can't compare it with the Haile Gebrselassie because it was a different course and there were a few more hills in it. But this is going to be a target of some consequence. A good target, too. It's going to be a race record, certainly, for both of these athletes. Certainly, Betsy Seiner and looks absolutely on her own, but deep in concentration. This is quite difficult for an athlete. It's a time trial, really, for her. And one would expect her to do well. She says it's a great honour to run in Scotland. She enjoys coming here through the streets and out into the country. Beautiful countryside, thoroughly enjoying it. And look at this, Callum Hawkins is away. Well, what about that? There's about 15 metres now, and last year's winner, Moses Kipsiro of Uganda, well, he's not gone with him. This is a superb break, second last year in 62:42, and he's now running sub-61. And this is fantastic. Look at the pace he's putting in. Remember, the last miles, 4:21, 4:20, and this is another quick one as well. There are 3 very quick miles at this late stage in this 13.1-mile journey, the half marathon, 21 kilometres, and this is sheer determination and the sign of a young man who has gained so much confidence this year from his marathon performances, and he's come here in front of his home crowd to do battle, and my goodness me, it looks as though he's turned the tables on Moses Kipsiro, the victor last year. Coming across the bridge and really towards now the final stage, you'll be into Clyde Street and then down towards the finish in Glasgow Green, and it'll be a wonderful, wonderful day for Scotland to see their man come in ahead of Africa, to see a great a British athlete beat a good, and I mean a good African athlete. Remember, he is twice marathon Commonwealth 10,000 metre champion. He's done it all. He was fourth in the Olympic 5,000 was Kipsiro back in Beijing. He's talented. Absolutely. First in the Scottish run last year, as I said. He also, I watched him in the Great South run too. He ran that in 46 minutes. But this is a different scene and a different part of the race. And Kipsiro is not going to make it back. Watch the clock, because this is going to be sub 61, that's for sure. It's going to be a personal best by a long, long way for this fella. He's come here with 62:39 set in Paris in March in 10th place. This is so much better, and he's going to be about 2 minutes quicker on the basis of this. And his last his last miles, 4:21, 4:20, 4:23, and a little bit slower on this one, but nevertheless he is definitely very close to the hour. Watch the clock. Callum Hawkins of Scotland from the Kilbarkan Club, second last year, establishing a time which is a very, very good world-class time for half marathon, close to the hour. And who would have expected that from this young man? So much to look forward to for him on the seasons to come with the World Championships last year. He's nearing the finish now. Round that bend and into the straight now. Wonderful, wonderful run. This is a brilliant time. He'll soon see the finish, and really, it's one of those, the McClellan Arch, through there, 200 metres to go. It's going to be outside the hour, but my goodness me, a personal best by about 2 minutes, probably more. And the crowd giving all the encouragement that he needs. He's seen off the man that beat him last year, Moses Kipsiro, a world-class man on the track and on the road. And Callum Hawkins wends his way towards the finish just outside the hour. Well, what a performance. He'll be delighted with this. This is taking him into a new era, totally and utterly into a new era. Anything close to the hour is world-class. Callum Hawkins is the great Scottish run champion for 2016. And he looks at the clock and he says, wow, what have I done? That's a 2 minute personal best by 2 minutes. And he thinks, how on earth have I done that? Well, he's beaten Kipsiro convincingly, hasn't he? Here comes the man. This year has to settle for second place. Positions reversed from 2015. But second place for Moses Kipsiro, just under the 62 minutes, but 61.24. Now Betsy Seiner still maintaining that pace. 68 minutes or better is going to be her target, that's for sure. She's ahead of Kiprop, ahead of Chang Yewo, ahead of Beth Potter, and there is the second placer, Hela Kiprop. Wonderful run she's had here, but man, my goodness me, has found it pretty tough against Betsy Seiner, hasn't she? But a 2:21 marathon runner, that woman, absolutely superb. But Betsy Seiner, well, I just wonder. I'm just looking to see whether in her career she will take on the marathon, and if she does, well, I can see that this is another great African marathon run. There are one or two coming through of late, and she'll be down in the final stages. She's very close to the finish. Look at that, 66 so far, and I reckon it's going to be inside 68. And she's really speeded up in the second half. The men's race, incidentally, was a negative split. In other words, the second half of the race faster than the first half. But this is a great run by Betsy Seiner. It's a lone vigil all the way round, and she will now be going through the McClellan arch and heading down now to that marker of 200 metres to go. 200 to go then, 66.39. It's going to be a very, very good time indeed. It's certainly going to be a new best. Remember, the previous best was by Edna Kiplagat. That was set in 2014. Slightly different on course terms, but 67.57 that was. And it looks to me as though it's going to be a little bit quicker than that. It's going to be close, 66.67 coming up. So she's very close to the finish. Just watch the clock now as she heads through the tape to take first place in this great Scottish run. And it has been a fine demonstration of power running by this young woman, Betsy Seiner, 28 years old now, and that's terrific stuff. 67.20 or thereabouts. Great, great run. Let's just confirm the result of the women's race then. Betsy Seiner, 67.22. Hela Kiprop, look, 68.52, inside 69. Then Doris Changyewo, 111, that's 71.34. Then Lily Partridge, Beth Potter, and the rest. But Callum Hawkins, wow, just outside the hour from Moses Kipsiro of Uganda. Big personal best for Callum Hawkins. Kimutai did hang on for third place, and Chris Thompson held on for fourth.
I wasn't expecting anywhere near as quick as I ran. I was hoping for more low 62s, but I'm just really pleased. I went out to win, and that's what I did. Yeah, I was just putting in the button, and I didn't really care about dying or not. I was going out for a win. I didn't want to come second again. I think marathon training seems to agree with me, but yeah, I took 2 weeks off, recovered, no running, a bit on the bike, and I've came back stronger, I reckon.
Some days you just like, you will never know how far you can go until you try it. So today I just thought like, okay, my personal best is 69.29. So, and I was like, okay, today I just want to go out there. I don't know what I'm running because I don't know how fit I am, because, you know, since Rio, after the Olympics, I haven't done much because I took a break and then I started running. So I just wanted to be like, okay, let me just go out there and have some fun and, you know, just be able to see people of Scotland on the way, just have fun, you know, and I just had an amazing race out there.
A perfect day then for both Glasgow and Scotland's own Callum Hawkins with a new race record. Well, next up for us, another half marathon, the Great Birmingham Run. And then it's off to Portsmouth and the 10 miles of the Great South Run. Well, keep up with events though on greatrun.org, but from Glasgow, goodbye.